for you. We're talking about a cat. He's got whiskers, he's got four legs, and he's probably traveled farther than most people have in their lives. Meet Simon, the traveling cat. What a cute guy. And his owners, Margaret and Bruce Erickson, are here. And Simon, there's a new book about him. Mm-hmm. Tell me, so this 70,000 miles, what was the idea here? What was the concept?
Well, when you think about it, it's rather silly because we adopted him from the Humane Society here. We live at Robson Ranch near Casa Grande. We adopted this cat without thinking that we had 3,500 miles to travel home. He was a great traveler.
3,500 miles, why is that?
Because we were living in Prince Edward Island, just north of Maine.
Oh, okay.
And we're in Arizona, so it was a 3,500-mile trip.
Gotcha. So you took him those 3,500 miles.
And every year we come back for 6 months.
Ah, I see. So back and forth.
Mm-hmm.
I see. So does he like it better in Rhode Island or here?
He likes it better in Robson Ranch, Arizona.
Okay, good. He's a local cat. He's a local cat.
He knows he's from Arizona. No. He likes it here.
Simon the cat, he was a sick kitty, right?
He was. He had an upper respiratory infection. The Humane Society nursed him back to health and then put him up for adoption. And we adopted him. And he's supposed to be an indoor cat. He does go out and run, but he's basically an indoor cat, and he's been healthy and happy ever since, 10 years.
And when you make this trek, do you make it by car or do you make it by plane?
A large truck.
A large truck. So how does Simon do on the road?
He's a great traveler. He has the entire back seat of the truck. And which is
room to roam.
Oh,
yeah.
Yes. Well, lots of foam and blankets and a little litter box and his food, and he's ready to go. Loves motels.
So for pet owners at home, are there any tips and tricks that you have for traveling with a cat?
With Simon, to have lots of water for him.
Sure.
We have his water supply. And just stop every so often.
Right. Let him out. Yeah.
He doesn't get out, but he likes to stop.
So the book is Simon the Cat, and it's The Adventures of a Very Special Kitty. And it's a children's book, and there are some great illustrations in there.
Yes.
It's kind of what's the target audience? Obviously kids and cat lovers, I would imagine.
Well, 4 to 80,
Four to 80, that's a wide audience.
4 to 10, okay. I would say. But, you know, so many people have bought the book and say they leave it on their coffee table for children to look at when they come in, and they end up reading it. It's a good story. It's based on a true story.
Oh, okay,
you
cool.
Know, it's how he was rescued, how we gave him a new home, and how he's adjusted, and he loves people, and he's just a happy kitty.
Margaret Erickson, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Simon the Cat is the book, and part of the proceeds benefit the local Humane Society as well.